Bam! Mr. Tarrou, in this video, we are going to extend the concepts we just learned in the last video, which is we're going to work with finding a unit vector. We're going to be talking about vectors that are collinear and magnitude, but in this time, instead of two-dimensional vectors, we're going to be working with a three-dimensional vector. And what's the differences? Well, honestly, not very much, other than it's so much harder to visualize three-dimensional vectors on your flat piece of paper. So we have vector A, which has, in component form, it is 2, negative 3, 5. Now this, if you're still pretty fairly unfamiliar with 3D space, is the number of unit vectors I you have, the number of unit vectors J you have, and the number of unit vectors K you have, or whatever your textbook may be calling it. But basically, we're talking about movement along the x-axis, movement along the y-axis, and movement along the axis z. And think about all the 3D printers that are coming out now, or three-axis routers, where the router or the printhead moves in two dimensions. It's moving along an xy-axis, and then the height, or the vertical distance, is the z-axis, or the z-axis. So we have the x-axis coming out. It looks like on a flat piece of paper, it's just going down to the left at a diagonal. But if you'll notice, these tick marks are a little bit closer together than they are along the y or z-axis, because we're trying to show you some depth, because actually what's happening is your x-axis is perpendicular to the y. Well, it's actually perpendicular to the z-axis too, but your x and your y-axis are horizontal. And then your z-axis, again, like I said earlier, was your vertical axis. So we have a vector A, and I'm just using the origin for convenience and for drawing this, move along the x-axis of positive 2 units, then move along the y-axis, not a positive but a negative distance of 3, and I'll just kind of drop this just down a little bit to help you see my orange movement, and then move up 5 units. So it's positive 2, negative 3, up 5, and you can do a rectangular solid with some dotted lines representing the sides of that rectangular solid to give you some kind of dimension and help you see that this vector is coming out towards you left and up. Okay, so at any rate, you can't find the unit vector unless you know the magnitude. So the magnitude of vector A, well, in two-dimensional space, it would be maybe V sub 1 squared plus V sub 2 squared. You might see x squared and y squared. You might see A and B, whatever your notation your textbook is using. And all you have to do for finding magnitude of a three-dimensional vector is just simply add in that same calculation for the third vector. So movement along the x-axis, y-axis, and now your movement along the z-axis. So finding a unit vector, well, remember that a unit vector is going to be 1 over the magnitude of whatever your given vector is. So we're going to do 1 over the magnitude of vector A times each of the components in that given vector. Okay, so magnitude of a three-dimensional vector. Well, that's going to be the square root of 2 squared plus negative 3 squared plus 5 squared. Now that's because we're finding a unit vector. That magnitude is going to be in the denominator, create the denominator of our scalar multiple. 1 over this becomes our scalar multiple, which we're going to multiply to vector A. And this comes out to be 1 over the square root. That's going to be 2 squared is 4, that's 9, 4 plus 9 is 13, 13 and 25 make 38. And our unit vector, therefore, is going to be 2 over the square root of 38. And I'm not going to rationalize these denominators. Negative 3 over the square root of 38. And finally, 5 over the square root of 38. And that is the unit vector. That vector in three-dimensional space has the same direction as the given vector from which we derived it from. Has the same direction as vector A. Therefore, it's collinear, by the way. yeah, and so instead of a length of square root of 38, a little over 6, it's going to be, it's going to mess up my drawing if I try and scribble all over this, but vector U is like right in here. Same direction, just a shorter magnitude, a shorter length. Find the vectors with magnitude of 4 that are collinear to A. Now, I said collinear, not in the same direction, which again, from a previous lesson, said that we could have both a positive and a negative scalar multiple, which means that our collinear vectors can either go in the same direction as vector A, positive scalar multiple, or it could be in the opposite direction with a negative scalar multiple. And our scalar multiple, well, we've sort of standardized, if you will, vector A down to a length of 1 with our vector u here. So now all I have to do is multiply this by 4. And if I multiply this by 4, we have that vector going in the same direction. It'll be still not as long as vector A, because I've only set the magnitude to be 4, which is less than the square root of 38, but you're going to have some vector in this direction and some vector in the opposite direction. So we're going to have 4 times this vector, vector u. Four times 2, 4 times negative 3, and 4 times 5. Now if I just change this to a negative 4, I'm going to get the exact same vector, but one going in the opposite direction. So I'm just going to say this, negative 4 times vector u, and this is going to be 4 times u is going to be, of course, it's the same thing with different signs. And that is how you work with unit vectors, find magnitude, and talk about or test collinearity for three-dimensional vectors. It's really just the same as two-dimensional, except for that really much more complicated drawing. I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go do your homework.